So, what do you think of when you imagine the second coming of Jesus? Some may picture the earth on fire, with the sound of trumpets and shouts in the air. Others think of a time when millions will instantly vanish from the earth. Many people even envision a day looming in our future that is preceded by famines, earthquakes, and even threats of nuclear holocaust. But what does the Bible say about the coming of the Lord? Jesus, for instance, speaks of the sun turning to darkness and the moon not giving its light. He talks about a time when stars would fall out of the sky and the heaven and the earth would move out of their place. At first glance, it may seem like we're headed towards a day of cosmic chaos. However, this is the same language used in passages like Isaiah 13 to describe the fall of nations such as Babylon. Even when God destroyed Egypt, as Isaiah talks about in chapter 19, the Bible describes him as riding on a cloud. To the first century disciples, Jesus wasn't describing the destruction of the universe, but the end of a nation. Jesus told his disciples that when they would see Jerusalem surrounded by armies, that they could be confident that the time had come for all things written to be fulfilled. He then said that it would happen within that generation, and even before some of them would die. Many are terrified that the day of the Lord may just happen tomorrow. But with a little bit of study, it can be shown that the day of the Lord happened 2,000 years ago at the destruction of Jerusalem in AD 70. For more information about Bible prophecy, contact info@christiansinarcadia.org or visit my website, www.labornotinvain.com. The fulfillment of Bible prophecy has not taken away my faith, but instead, it strengthened my faith more than ever, and I know that it will yours too.